Hey, what's up guys, Jeremy here. Grippers are commonly used in robotic stations, so let's see how you can create and animate your own custom ones in RoboDK. Let's get started. For this example, let's open the online library. Here under type, you will find gripper. Here you will have a bunch of grippers, either the animated one or just the 3D models. Remember in the pick and scan example, we used the RoboTiQ 2F85 opened and closed. So those are just the 3D models that we were doing the hide and show method to animate. But here you have the RoboTiQ 2Finger 85, but the mechanism option. So if we open this one and drag it to RoboDK, we can hide the frame. And if we double click on it, you can open and close the gripper. So this is a quite complex mechanism. You won't be able to recreate the same thing in RoboDK where for a custom one, we are only able to create simple linear two-finger gripper motions. But if you need the RoboTiQ one, you already have it right here. So you can create positions for it. So let's say create a position open, create a target, create a position, let's say, almost or halfway through, and then a position completely closed. Then you can create a program with that, create the program where you here. Oops. Okay, this, and here those needs to be joint motions. They can't be linear motions in this case here. It's not a linear movement. But just like that, you have your three positions. Or you could have one program for open, close, or mid open. So yeah, cool. Here you also have a bunch of other two-finger grippers, but we'll come back to those later here. In this example, we will open the 06C gripper and we will bring all the files there that we have here. So just like that here, we have the base of our gripper and we have two different fingers. So finger one and finger two and the gripper base. I will create a frame again here, call it frame base as usual, and I will reset its position so that it's just at the root of the station here. I can go to utilities and model mechanisms or robot. In here, I can select two finger gripper. So let's call this one gripper simply. Then you can go and select the right frame, in this case frame base, and select the different 3D model objects. So here you have the Schunk gripper as your base, and then you have finger one and then finger two as your fingers. Minimum limit will be zero and maximum limit, I know this one here is about 40. So if I click update, I will have my panel appearing here. And as you can see here, oops, it doesn't do anything because I was looking at the 3D models from the beginning and not at the one I just created. So as you can see here, we have the gripper, but we can't, it doesn't move, let's say exactly where, how we would like it to move. So it starts from zero here and it goes up to 40, but first of all, in the wrong direction. So one thing you can try is select simply invert and click update. So from here, it does go in the right direction. Here the value should be 80, it looks like. Click update. And just like that, it goes from fully open to fully closed. But the issue is we should have fully closed when we're at zero and fully opened when we're at 80, not the other way around. So using the invert is not what we want in this case here. So to solve that, you have two solutions. First one is either saying RoboDK, what were the position of those finger when you used the built joint? So in this case, it was 80. So I could select update. And now I will have zero here and 80 when it's fully opened from zero to 80. Another solution that I can have, if this is at zero, I can bring back the 3D models I had. And what I would recommend you is to move the fingers in their zero position before you get started with the whole create mechanism wizard. So if you click update like this here, you can now, oops, and then we need to zoom back because we don't want to see this here. Now, if we click update, we have from 0 to 80 here. So as we have open and closed ratio, that means that we'll have 80 millimeters in between the two fingers. So each finger will have a stroke or a pat of 40 millimeters. If we were to enter a open close ratio of 1, we would have to enter 40 to just tell how much each finger will move. But generally, it will depend on how your gripper works. Does it requires you to give it the input value as one of the finger position or the distance between the two fingers? Generally, if it's the distance between the two fingers, you go for 0.5 here and you enter the full stroke between the two fingers. So that's the first thing. Also here, as you can see, your end effector is not really positioned where it should be. So in this case, it's 150, but you could kind of measure. Let's go for 180, 185, let's say. Long Z update. And now you can see TCP is at the right spot. Okay, and let's click on okay. Now there's something else we need to change here. As you can see, we have here a bunch of frames that are appearing and we don't really know why they're here. And I can right click, I can remove visible robot flange, but still I have this here and I have that there that I can't get rid of. So here, listen to me very carefully. To be able to get rid of those, you have to press Ctrl, Alt, Shift, and G. So Ctrl, Alt, Shift, and G. So a G like a G. And like golf. And you will have to go for, do you want to enter the developer mode? You will select yes, double click the gripper once again, and now you have a full on robot panel where you can remove the tool frame and the ref frame and you're left with just the gripper. Then when it's done, you can close that. Press again, Ctrl, Alt, Shift, and G. I would recommend you not to stay in developer mode as there is some stuff that can be a bit wicked. So it's a way for us to kind of do stuff or test out some features without you, let's say, stumbling on those because they are not necessarily finished. But here, this shouldn't be hidden behind that, but for the moment it is. So if at some point you can, by just double clicking, change the tool and flange and frame, that would be awesome. But for now, you have to do the little procedure of Control Alt Shift and G. Okay, so back to the library. You can see here we have a bunch of Schunk gripper with or without, in fact, any fingers attached to them. So if I bring that here, I'm gonna hide this one here, right click, frame on. You'll see that we have a bunch of those. And here we just have the fingers. In fact, we have the socket to attach the fingers, but we don't have the fingers themselves. So what you can do is right click on them and then modify robot. By doing so, it will kind of re-explode the robot or the mechanism in the small pieces, in the smaller pieces here. So if I go reframe here, you will have the base, one finger, and the other finger. So what you can do is design your own fingers. I will go grab some 3D models here that I have, shapes here, and let's go for simple cylinder. I'll bring those cylinder here. I'm going to convert all of those to objects here. I'm going to bring that down here. And I have that cylinder somewhere. I'm going to bring it here. And I'm going to reframe on. Perfect. I'm going to scale that down a bit. So let's go scale that 0.5 here. Excellent. And I'm simply going to move that up here and then move that here. So obviously this is just a demo. Control C and then Control V here. And plus 30. So just like that, click okay. Then I need to simply merge. So I want this and this together, right click, merge, and then this and this together, right click, merge. So now I have one and two. Okay, perfect. So now I have two fingers. I'm gonna call it finger one and then finger two. Let's say, and this will be base. So here in my modify mechanisms, I can simply go ahead and select the right reference frame, the one that was created automatically. I can select the base, finger one, and then finger two. I have nothing to change for the rest. Everything stays the same, apart if I want to change the stroke or something like that. I can click update and then right click and then frame on here. And now I have, here I would have to invert those, it seems like. Would have to invert those update here from zero to fully opened. So just like that, I added some custom fingers to an already existing two finger gripper. So that's an easy way to just like design your own. You bring this one in here, right click, modify, and then you're able to customize the tip of the fingers to match exactly your specific requirements. One thing important to be noted is this is just a mechanism. This is not the TCP. You will still have, I'm gonna show you that later, but you will still have to create the actual TCP if you wanna attach or detach objects. So the gripper is, they are more for to show some level of realisticness of your simulation, but it won't be the one actually picking up the objects. That's pretty much everything for today's video. I hope you liked it. In the next one, we'll talk about doors. So how you can animate sliding doors or normal rotative doors. So in any case, have a great day, guys.